You have probably heard of the famous monsoon winds and associate them correctly with Southern Asia. However, many places in the world experience the effects of monsoonal style systems, including Southern California during the summer months. A monsoon wind is a wind that reverses its direction between the seasons, particularly between the summer and winter seasons. This means that at one time of the year, this means usual movement, the prevailing winds are blowing from one direction, and at another time of the year, the winds are blowing from a different direction. This alternating direction is the result of changing high and low pressure systems. Certainly, you have heard someone on the news broadcasting the upcoming weather with something akin to, "There will be persistent high pressure dominating the region over the next 5 days," or something like that, right? I'm going to explain what that means. Take a look at this diagram. We're going to return to it as I go through the monsoonal system in Asia, but first, let's look at it. If you look at the left-hand side, you can see there's a sun, it says warm air, and it says high. Don't worry about the warm and cold air part of this that you see on there. Let's just look at the part of the diagram to the left. The blue arrows indicate the movement of air. And what's happening is, with high pressure, the air is coming down from above and it's going towards the surface of the planet. And as it does that, it diverges outwards. Notice on the other side, you can see that it says low, and the air is coming together and it's rising, and then you see clouds. This is basically describing the movement of air within high and low pressure systems. And at the moment, this is the thing that you need to be most concerned with and most focused on, and that is the movement of the air itself. As I said, with high pressure, the air in the atmosphere descends, which means it flows downward, and it diverges. High pressure is associated with clear skies and dry air. Southern California is dominated throughout most of the year with high pressure. This is the reason that we have this very, very dry climate that we tend to have. In a low pressure system, the air converges, that means it comes together, and it rises. This converging, rising air is associated with making clouds, and clouds, of course, are associated with making precipitation. Those are the fundamental mechanics of the monsoons, high pressure and low pressure. Let's look again at the movement on this diagram. Notice on the left-hand side with high pressure, the air is descending and diverging. As I said, don't worry about the warm air part or the cold air part. And then notice on the right-hand side where you see the low, which means low pressure, the air is converging and it's rising. And at the same time it's doing this, as it rises, it tends to make clouds. In addition to these alternating pressure systems, four things bring about the monsoons in Asia. Here's what they are. Warm air rises and cold air subsides. This is why I didn't want you to pay too much attention to what they wrote on that diagram. Because if you have warm rising air creates low pressure, and if you have cold subsiding air creates high pressure. Land masses, a land mass is something like a continent. So land masses heat up faster and they cool off faster than water bodies. A water body would be something like an ocean. Air will absorb water if it's given the opportunity. The atmosphere is something like a sponge. If you set a dry sponge in a pan of water, the dry sponge is going to begin to absorb water. The atmosphere works in a very similar way. If it's given the opportunity to absorb water, the air will absorb water. And the warmer the air, the greater the amount of water it can hold, the greater the amount of water it can absorb. Asia is a unique physical landscape. This unparalleled landscape establishes the conditions that make the monsoons such a massive and critical annual event on the continent. Asia is the largest land mass on Earth, and much of Asia is very far north. Because of these site characteristics, remember site is physical characteristic, During the winter, Central Asia becomes exceptionally cold. I mean, like minus 40, minus 50, minus 60 degrees Fahrenheit. And since cold air subsides, a large high-pressure system is established over Central Asia during the winter months. During the summer, because of what is known as the continental influence or the continental effect, Central Asia becomes quite hot. Hot air rises. This creates a large low-pressure system over the continent during those summer months. Take a look at these diagrams. First, on the left-hand side, you could see H that represents high. Notice that what's happening is the air, which is represented by the arrows, is being pushed off the continent. And it says in the bottom left-hand side, winter monsoon. Remember, during the winter, it's going to get very cold. Cold air subsides, subsiding air creates high pressure. Then look at the right-hand side. You can see there's two L's that represents low pressure. It says summer monsoon. During the summer, it gets hot in Asia. Hot air rises, creating low pressure. And notice what's happening, which is that those red arrows are indicating that the air is being sucked in off the ocean towards those low pressure systems. Winter is, therefore, the dry season in Asia. Although the continent is about the same latitude as much of North America, seasonally they operate very differently from California. As you know in the previous diagram, in the winter, the air originates on land and then it flows offshore towards the ocean. These offshore winds are dry. During the summer, owing to the hot rising air and its associated low pressure, air is drawn in from the ocean towards the Asian landmass, again, as we saw in that previous diagram, and as we'll see momentarily in another diagram. Because the air takes on the characteristics of whatever it's over, this onshore flow of air is wet, having started out over the ocean. And it's not only wet, it's warm and wet. And remember that warm air can hold more water. So summer ends up being the wet season for most of Asia. Both the Indian and the Pacific Oceans are tropical oceans at those latitudes. So they're hot. And as a result of that, when that air begins to flow in towards the Asian continent, it's warm and it's wet and it brings massive amounts of precipitation. Now, this makes for a very pronounced wet season in Asia during the summer. How does that impact life there? Well, rice was first domesticated in Asia, probably in what is today the southern part of Vietnam in the Mekong River Delta area. It would have been a naturally growing grass. And how do you grow rice? You grow rice in a flooded field. As it turns out, rice is the perfect crop for large swaths of Asia from a climatological sense. Rice is also the single most consumed grain on Earth. Basically, much of Asia sets its watch by the flow and movement of the monsoons because of the need to feed the enormous populations in East, Southeast, and Southern Asia. One last look at these maps to refresh your mind about the mechanics of the monsoons in Asia. Notice on the left-hand side, the winter monsoon is the dry monsoon. The air starts out over the continent because of cold air and high pressure. It flows offshore, and then during the summer months, because of hot rising air, low pressure systems are created, and that draws the air in off the tropical ocean, which produces vast amounts of precipitation.